Hi everybody. So my name is Justine and today I'm going to talk about my top five hikes here on Oahu. So my number five is definitely going to be Cocoa Head. What I like about Cocoa Head is it's hard. And I know that sounds weird. It's a difficult hike. It's pretty much going like pretty steep uphill the entire time. It's very treacherous. It is pretty difficult. And yet it's very rewarding when you get up to the top. I definitely suggest being prepared with water. You need to have hiking shoes for this. It's like the trail is pretty much like a old railroad tracks, and they're not all really still stable or new, obviously, because this is old. So you're going to be pretty much climbing up on those, and each one of those will essentially be your step. And there's also a section where there's kind of like nothing underneath you but those steps. So you definitely want to be prepared and have the right equipment for this hike. Once you get up to the top, there's like some bunkers, kind of like pillboxes up there, but there's an incredible view looking back towards Honolulu. And then there's a great view on the other side looking further east, which I think is one of my favorite things about it, is you kind of get a view of two different viewpoints from one spot on the island. Just make sure you definitely bring enough water. I have done it 3 or 4 times now, and every time I've done the hike, there's been somebody that ran out of water, either because they didn't bring enough or they brought a dog with them. And just be mindful too that there will be people coming up and down, so just be polite of, you know, making sure you move out of the way if you're moving a little bit slower, because there's kind of people that are running up this. They do it all the time. They'll run up and down. You might catch them back up on a second run. So just be aware of kind of other people around you while you're on the hike, because there's not a lot of space. Number four will be the pink pillbox. So I say the pink pillbox, but there's more than one. There's actually a total of 4 up there, if I'm correct. There's one that's a little bit further down that I've never been to, but then there's 3 up top. A lot of time people stop at just the pink pillbox, but there's actually a couple. It's a great hike though. It doesn't take very long. It's about 20-30 minutes if you hike, but it's a beautiful view from up there. I think it's a little underrated because it is out west, but I have to tell you, I mean, if you're able to make it out there, it really is. It's a great hike for sunrise. I've done it for sunrise. It's a beautiful hike for sunset. So if you're able to make it out there, I would definitely say for me, it's hard to even put it at number 4 because it's such a great hike, but it's definitely my number 4. So number 3 is gonna be Lanikai. So I would love for Lanikai to be higher up on this list too. We got engaged at Lanikai and it's one of our favorite hikes. It's not super difficult. Another incredible view. All of these have great views, honestly. But the reason why I would put it above the other two so far is just because it's a little bit easier. It really has a gorgeous, gorgeous sunrise. I've probably done this hike the most out of all the hikes on the island. And it's really just gorgeous. The only thing is you just gotta be mindful that there will be a lot of people and you are in people's neighborhood. So that's kind of one of the things about this hike, is that you can't really park where it begins. You gotta park on the street, and on the street is where people's houses are. So just be aware of that. You know, you don't want anybody disrupting you in your neighborhood. You know, show that same respect while you're there. That's one thing. And it is a very popular hike because it's in Lanikai. And so just be aware that there might be a lot of people. I would say if you're gonna do it, try to do it during like the weekday. Sunrise will be busy because it's sunrise. So, you know, if you're trying to avoid the crowd a weekday, probably during the day, just be aware then it might be a little bit hot. Lanikai is awesome. It's beautiful. There's a lot to do over there too. You can definitely hit the beach right afterwards, which makes it super great because you are going to work up a little bit of a sweat. And just be mindful also on this hike to have hiking shoes, because you are doing some incline. And if it's muddy, you will kind of be screwed. So make sure you got some good shoes. There are some ropes to pull yourself up during some of the inclines, so just be mindful of that, but it's definitely worth it. It's a beautiful view at the end. And also, just so I don't forget, there are 2 pillboxes, so don't feel like you gotta just stay at the first one or skip the first one. Both of them are both a little bit different, and be aware that I think they locked one of them now that you can't go inside of the pillbox, so just be aware that you may not be able to get into them because they may have it locked for some reason. So number 2 is gonna be Ka'a Crater Hike. Kama Crater hike definitely would have been my number one had you asked me a week ago, but I did another hike, which now moved to my number one. But anyway, Kama Crater hike is awesome. First of all, there's three waterfalls. The last one, you get to scale it pretty much. I mean, you're like climbing ropes to get up it, which is like right next to the waterfall. I mean, it's pretty awesome. And then after you finish that, there's like this huge crater that's right in front of you. And I will tell you, I at that point could not do the whole crater. Like, you can hike and walk around the whole crater. We did not do that because just seeing the view of the crater from where we were was great enough for me. I felt like I was like in the Pride Lands in Lion King. So awesome. But just be aware, this is a difficult hike. So as I've said with all the other ones, bring water, because I actually ran out of water. Make sure you have hiking shoes, because even with my hiking shoes, my feet were killing me. And make sure you take some snacks and stuff too, because it is rather long. Us having not done the whole crater, I think it was about 5 hours. So if you're gonna do the whole crater, I think that adds about another 2 hours or so. So just be aware of that. But definitely gotta do it. And then last but not least, if you're a hiker, then this will be expected, is definitely Stairway to Heaven. Stairway to Heaven, I'm still sore, honestly. It's been like 4 days since I did it, and my body is not 100% recovered yet, but it was definitely worth it. I would definitely say there are people who were passing us and who passed us again on the way back. So we were definitely moving in slow motion. However, just be aware that if you're not like a super avid hiker, it's gonna take you some time. It took us about 4 hours to get there. We were there for about an hour and then 4 hours to get back. So just be aware, you know, bring water, bring snacks, bring the right shoes. Like I said, I would even bring gloves, especially for this and the last one, because you will be holding on to a lot of things, pulling yourself up. There's a lot of ropes, a lot of climbing. So like, just be prepared. Make sure you have what you need. You may decide to take the stairs. That is the legal route. And if you decide to take the stairs, I don't really have any advice for you, because I did not do it. The only thing that I could say about the stairs is if it's raining, they are slippery. That's really all I can say. I did stand on them to take some pictures. I probably shouldn't say that because that's technically illegal, but I did, and they were slippery and it had me nervous, and I didn't even take the stairs all the way up. So just be aware of that. But I would say, I mean, try to do it on a clear day where you can really see, because otherwise you're just up in the fog. And I will tell you, when I got up there, it was just fog and cloud and I couldn't see anything. But it was super awesome when they lifted. It was like the heavens literally arose. So for me, those are my top five hikes. I mean, there's a lot of other awesome hikes on the island too. It's just, those are the top five, I would say, that you have to do if you're gonna come here. And if you love to hike, gotta do those. Just be prepared. Make sure you're gonna have some rest that you can be able to get while you're here, if that's what you're planning to do. So if you like this video or you want more content or anything, you know, feel free to put down below in the comments what you would like there to be a video about, anything to do with Oahu or Hawaii. And if not, then just like, share, and subscribe.